I just got the crazy opportunity to fly my aircraft in a 5-mile high-speed race across the desert, competing against some of the best undercover road racers in the world.
Wait a second, we got trouble here. The SkySurfer aircraft is starting to become unstable.
I can't believe this is a thing that real people do. Death Valley is known as one of the hottest places in the world, and judging by its name, I'm not sure it wants us to be there. Flying in this desert environment means pushing the limits of the SkySurfer aircraft far into the danger zone, and when I faceplant, it will end up in a music video because this is one of those big-time music labels filming with the same crew that makes videos for people like Taylor Swift.
I'm not sure exactly how I got here. This is a test of skill, mental stamina, all fueled by a passion to win or die trying. It's a whole lot of stuff that I don't really have.
But I'm guessing they know impossible challenges are all I do on this channel because they just told me it's in 3 days and on the other side of the country. Luckily, the cheapest flights are always the longest, so we've got a solid 24 hours to come up with a plan. You see, when your back is up against a wall and there's something you have to do, fear kicks in, takes over, and that's a powerful thing to get you to where you need to go. I like to think we all have our own purpose in life. For me, I decided a long time ago that I'm on this planet with one mission, to build a future where personal flight vehicles exist. So even if I'm risking everything, I've got to say yes to anything that has even a slight chance of helping me get one step closer to reaching that goal.
Two different Delta employees assured me that my bag was going to be here. My connecting flight got me here too late.
Apparently the car rental place is closed, so now I have no vehicle and my checked bag is gone. I think I literally just must have bad luck.
After traveling all the way here, I've got exactly 24 hours left to install and test a series of desert-rated SkySurfer parts. We get this stuff custom made, so it's a bit too pricey for me to just have laying around ready to go. With our back up against a wall and a deadline which I'm legitimately not sure is even possible, this is the point where we enter phase two, which is what I call the grind. All I can do is put my head down and work as hard as physically possible until tomorrow morning. Scraping this footage together is pretty hard. It always bugs me that I can't even think about picking up a camera to share these parts with you guys, but even if I did, I'm not sure how to explain how mentally challenging it is to continue pushing forward in situations like this. My life depends on every bolt that we screw into the doohickeys, so that adds a whole new level of exhaustion because no mistakes can be made. The SkySurfer aircraft doesn't crash, and that's because I programmed about 100 different alarms that will force you to land safely if something bad happens.
Critical motor temperature.
But to compete in this race, the last thing we need to do is turn everything off to get us into more of a sport mode. Otherwise, the SkySurfer is not going to clock in for work. The storm is coming, but I'm prepared. After a solid 20 hours of work, today is the big day.
That's not looking good. Stop, stop, stop.
I've got everything packed up and we're ready to head into the desert, but for the past hour, we've been fighting against the universe, trying to tell us not to go. This house is doing everything possible to trap us in here.
That is a big problem.
That's how you shut the gate with a stick.
I beat it with a stick until it moved, but I should have known better about fighting against the universe. It must have been really mad after that one because it came back at me full force.
That semi's close to your door, dude. Gotta get down, dude.
Yeah, we gotta get out of here.
Oh my god, that was so terrifying.
I was so scary.
Okay, this doesn't normally happen. This wind out here is bizarre.
It's pushing down the roof.
We're driving through some areas in California that are known for having crazy fast wind speeds that can even knock you over when you get outside of your car.
Another highway stop.
Oh man. Stakes are higher because it's my life. Every time I hear that thing bang into the side up there, it just makes me cringe.
Like, speaking of safety, remember that bag Delta lost on the way here? That had all of my flight gear, including helmet, goggles, and everything else that I absolutely cannot fly without.
We're almost there. Let's just stop recording. Nobody wants to see everything going wrong.
I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do.
This looks terrible. Everything has gone perfectly fine. We're here, we're on time, we brought all the equipment. We're going 5 miles per hour because this is a terrible road. Like, I don't know how stable. Oh, but all right, we're slowing down. I just can't do it.
Pretty much everything has gone wrong. So after an hour of crawling down this road, I was starting to accept this might not happen and that the past few days were all for nothing. This whole wild experience has been such a reminder to me just how easy it is to give up when sometimes right on the other side of just giving up is the thing you've been working towards this whole time. A wide open, flat desert track at 120 degrees Fahrenheit, intentionally placed in a far out location where laws don't exist. I'm getting the feeling that this isn't a friendly race, but it's hard to know for sure since there's not much English going on. I hear some Ukrainian, but this guy is the only one I can actually understand. I'm pretty sure that translates to something like, you're gonna lose. Luckily, there's one guy that I know. This is Tungavag, one of the top DJs in the world, and this whole race is being turned into a music video for one of his new songs. He and the director are the reason I'm here, so I can't say enough how much I appreciate them, but even more importantly, you guys watching who are the ones making all of this possible by following along for the journey here. Meanwhile, I'm over here in the shade wondering, should we tell him that we're stepping into some unknown record-breaking territory over here?
I'm setting up right now real quick, trying to make sure all the wires are set. There's no strain on any of the connectors from that travel. It's pretty windy, just destroying and blowing stuff around.
The only rule in this race is that everyone needs to start at the same time. So to make sure we're all on the same page, our last step is to run through a couple takeoffs before we start. My original plan was to test everything in the morning and then recharge the batteries for the big race. Since we no longer have time for any of that, all I'm focused on now is fixing last minute problems like loose bolts.
I'm out here in the middle of the desert. It's so hot out here and all the cars left me, so we all can't start at the same time. I'm getting faster every time, more comfortable with it.
I'm pretty exhausted at this point, but since I'm flying in a sport mode with most of the safety features turned off, I need everything operational. If something like a motor goes out, everything else will need to kick into overdrive to make up for it. With the amount of energy that this takes, we could power at least 8 average American homes. That amount of raw power at your fingertips is an incredible feeling.
Well, that was pretty high, but I got left in the dust.
That was sick.
Was it?
Yeah, it looked amazing.
The more you do it, it's like addicting. But you can see I'm like starting to take off faster too. And yeah, I can get more and more aggressive with it. Gotta be bad for me.
At this point, I think we're as ready as can be, and I've got to put the rest of this into the hands of the universe and hope for the best. Any minute now, the team's going to give us the go-ahead to line up at the start.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. And finally, the moment we've all been waiting for as the racers line up for the start of this competition with a desire to win at any cost. And they're off. And the red Dodge jumps out to an early lead. Wait a second, we got trouble here. Halting to a stop is the Plymouth, and she chucks the heels.
What happened?
I'm a winner, you know? Not today.
The Camaro is looking frustrated as he's falling behind. And there he goes. It looks like he's been forced to activate his nitrous oxide system. Looks like the top-down Jeep is slowing down, and yep, that is. That's a blown engine, folks. He's down and out of this race. These drivers are battling extreme engine temperatures out in this desert heat. Approaching 3 miles in, we're halfway through the race. Now is when the drivers will have to rely on strategy to win. This is a risky move here by the SkySurfer. He appears to be flying closer to the ground to create a dust storm to blind the motorcyclists. The SkySurfer aircraft is starting to become unstable. He's starting to wobble. And oh, he's turned into a giant ball of dust. Right next door with two others remaining, the motorcycle clearly has speed. This is risk versus reward as he floors it, doing whatever it takes to get the job done. And we have ourselves a winner.
Even though we got last place, thank you guys for helping to create a future for the SkySurfer aircraft by subscribing to this channel and following along for the journey here.